Qu'est-ce que c'est que l'écologie de la santé? Et
what
pourquoi
is
écologie
health
globale?
ecology and why
écologie,
talk
c'est la
about
science
overall ecology, global ecology? Ecology
et,
is the science of the relations between the environment
santé,
and living beings, and health ecology
santé,
is the effect
santé,
on the environment
santé,
on
santé,
public
santé,
health, an individual's health, and the global environmental effect. We don't limit ourselves to infections or the various infectious agents, but we include pesticides and all kinds of external agents, weather, the temperature, the sea pH level, all the environmental elements that are being slowly modified by man activity. What can we say to conclude? In the field of health policies, we need health markers. There are already quite a few around, but we need more. And we need to develop a science called health ecology. Simple problems of public health that are not yet solved, which are still unanswered. Epidemiology. Easy access to registries regarding incidence of infections in terms of morbidity and not only mortality and emerging risks. It's very easy to find data on mortality, but it's difficult to get data registries on diseases. It's more difficult to organize, obviously, and those registries are not readily available. The same goes for emerging risks. An independent and detailed analysis of regarding toxicity of all of the compounds, including pesticides, herbicides, and substances that have an impact on the endocrine system. Something important was reminded not very long ago. The toxicity curve of a number of compounds, especially those that have an effect on the endocrine system, are not a monotonic curve. It's a non-monotonic curve. Toxicity based on the dose provides two peaks. And depending on whether you measure toxicity in the slow, in the weak, or the strong peak, you find or you don't find toxicity. So it's a matter of having large scales of toxic compounds to analyze. That matters and makes a difference.
Ça doit porter sur les produits sur le marché.
This must cover products that already are on the market or are about to be released on the market.
Sur plan européen, mais c'est certainement
on a European level,
un aspect qui est actuellement nécessiterait des
this is already felt, but I think that we still have some work to do and more research. Some regional systems have been created to indicate geographical dissemination of bacteria and emerging mutants for organic pollutants and non-organic pollutants. And the last thing that I would like to lay the emphasis on is that we need to sue all the thieves, charlatans, and paranoid people who, because they suffer from paranoia or have a hidden agenda, have raised doubts on the basis of pseudoscientific undemonstrated data. One or two mediatic examples would be more than welcome. Scientists, such as the ones for the climate GIEC, who meet all 600 of them to write hundreds of pages of reports documented and not just based on single observations and personal individual declarations need support to be able to continue working. The real issue is that restoring biodiversity in the various habitats, including our guts and the bacteria that inhabit our guts, and also tinea and viruses, is changing our immune system as well as our metabolic balance, equilibrium. There have been several medical observations and papers published. There are examples of the microbiome interaction with diseases. The stomach ulcer is now an infectious disease, but possibly Parkinson's disease as well. So the stomach ulcer no longer needs you to go to a psychiatrist, but rather that you should take antibiotics to kill Helicobacter pylori and the patient is treated within a matter of weeks. Therefore, the changing microbiota is probably an essential determining factor for the increase of the incidence of autoimmune diseases, and this has an impact on public health. Now, a question that was raised during a conference that we organized with Gilles Boeuf twice, last year was the last edition. Can man adjust to himself, adjust to his own detrimental activities or beneficial activities? Environmental changes that are taking place are of human origin. They are not due to God's will or anything else. They are due to human activity, and they are about to become irreversible. And the major issue is not so much to find whether we can reduce the environmental changes, but how and how far we can adjust to them. I'm not being pessimistic. I don't think we can go back on the sea acidification, and definitely not anytime soon. So we will need to adjust to this change and many others. And if man is going to adjust to some of its activities, it must be done on the global level. And this means a certain degree of governance, taking into consideration determining factors such as socioeconomic and cultural inequalities. You're not in the same situation facing a bacterium or if you are a rich company owner in Germany or a vagrant in Paris. And unfortunately, one of the major elements is the unfairness with which resources have been distributed. Man, as all living species, does not live alone. It coexists with a number of living species that depend on him or that he depends from, and the vast majority of the species belong to the microbial world. Again, if you want to find out more, I will be publishing a book very soon called For a Global Ecology of Health, and I recommend you to read this book if you're interested. Thank you.